So here we have some curves similar to the curves that we laid out before, and we're going to use these as the basis to make a ring with T-splines. So just like we did before, to make a surface with this, we are going to turn on the manipulator and then hold down the Alt key to drag this up. And you can see now we have a T-splines ribbon that looks like a heart. This is just a paper-thin surface right now. So to create a surface from it, what should we do? Or create a volume from it, what should we do? We'll go ahead and thicken it. So just select this T-spline, hit Enter. And now again, so you can thicken outside or inside. And again, we can type the distance here. But in this case, I'm just going to kind of eyeball it and just hit Enter. And you can see now I've got this... this thickened heart. I had my creased edges on option on, which I'm not going to want here, so I can either undo that or I can just select all these edges and hit the remove crease command. So let's go ahead and remove that crease. You can see now it's a smooth T-spline. Okay, so I have this heart here, and now I need to create the main part of the ring. So I'll do that same procedure. I'm just going to hold down Alt and drag to get some distance here. And by the way, I've just been freehanding this, but if I undo this and double-click while holding down Alt, then it lets me enter in an exact distance for how long I want this to be. So let's see what 2 gets us. Not too bad. So this is 2 units wide now. So again, we'll go ahead and grab this and thicken this. We can get a volume here. So go ahead and turn off the crease edges this time and thicken that up. And with this ring, we want to have, again, just take a look at the final one. We're going to want to have 2 of these bands coming down. So to do that, we'll go ahead and copy this. Let's see, it looks like I need to turn off my edge mode, go to object mode so I can select it. Let's see. Yeah, let's change to a different viewport. There we go. So now we've made a copy of this. And I'm just going to just use the T-splines manipulator to position these better into where I want them to come into the heart. So I want these to kind of transition into the heart at the bottom and at the top. So now that these are in position, I'm going to use the bridge command to bridge these together. So one thing, the bridge command works on edges or faces. And you can see my faces are kind of small and skinny here, and frankly kind of hard to see. So when we're doing commands that require us to use edges or faces and they're hard to make out, I like to use the T-spline smooth toggle, and I'll just toggle everything. And this just gives me a kind of a boxy mess representation of what the T-spline's topology looks like. And it just makes it a lot easier to see where all the faces are. And so I can do the bridge command and it'll just be easier to work. So now that I can see this, I'll just move this a little bit so that it's lining up better with the faces. And go ahead and use that bridge command. So just like we did previously, the bridge command, we select one group of faces and another group of faces. And make sure these arrows are lined up and in the right corners. So I have one segment and just hit enter. And we'll do that again here. So run the bridge command. Select this face, select this face. And again, those are wound the right way, so I'll hit enter. I'll go ahead and smooth toggle back so we can kind of see what the model's looking like now. So you can see we've got, these are transitioning rather nice. So you can see there's, the ISO curves are kind of crazy, and we'll address that in a second. But let's go ahead and finish bridging first. So I'll switch back my smooth toggle and do this bridge. And bridge this up. And it's kind of hard for me to see if these are wound the right way, so I'm just going to click here because I know these corners should be lining up together and make sure that the arrows are pointing the same way so I can make sure that that bridge is going well. Then we'll do it again here. You can also pre-select the faces before you go into the bridge command. And that looks good. Okay, so now we've got the kind of the topology that's laid out. Let's go ahead and smooth toggle back and see what our surface is looking like. Okay, so everything's hooked together, but it looks a little bit crazy here. Whenever you do operations like bridge or something where you're combining surfaces and it looks crazy afterwards, one thing that I always like to do after that is to run the this make uniform command. So you do that by right-clicking on the edit layout button. And then after that, it does an amazing job at cleaning up the surface. Look how much nicer that looks. And what that does is just kind of relaxes everything that after the bridge. So all of a sudden we've got a very nice smooth surface. And look at these transitions. Remember, this is still a T-spline, so you can still move these around. And you can move the edges. You can click here to move or faces or edges. And the surface just updates beautifully. It just stays nice and smooth there. Okay, so now we've got this ring like this, but if we want to bring these two rings together and join them so that they turn into one, that's another thing that's pretty simple to do with T-splines. Let's go ahead and do that. First, what I'll do is move the faces so that they're closer to each other. So I'll do that by making sure I have my faces selected and then just selecting these and just dragging them over here. You can see up here my surface is updating smoothly as it kind of has the effect of these mood faces influencing it. So now I've got these closer, and I could do two things. One is I could bridge this if I wanted to create additional surface there, but I'm going to go ahead and actually use the merge command because I want this to just merge up nicely. And the merge command, it merges edges, not faces, so first I need to delete these faces. So I'm going to go back to my box mode by smooth toggling just so I can see the faces easier. I'm just going to select these interior four faces on each side and delete them. Just hitting the delete button. So you can see we've got those. Anyway, there's a hole there. Let's go ahead and smooth toggle. You can see while I had those faces deleted, kind of this intermediate step, then the surface, it kind of looks like a zipper that's waiting to be zipped up or closed. So as soon as we merge this up, this will look a lot smoother. I'm just going to go ahead and move the faces a little bit closer together just because I want there to be as little movement as possible when I actually do the merge. But now I'll switch to my edge mode. And I'm just going to do a selection of all of these interior edges. Let's go back to perspective viewport so we can see what I have selected. I just have all of the edges selected that I want merged together. And when you run when you select edges before you run the merge command, then both pairs of edges will move and be met in the middle. If I was to select one pair and then the second pair, then the first pair would be moved to the second pair. But since these are both selected before I go to the command, then they'll both just meet in the middle. So run this merge command, and you can see, wow, let's redo that just to see what happened. Here we had everything kind of blocked out, and then after we merge it, everything is a lot, I mean, everything's merged together, but it's merged quite smoothly. So you see here we have that nice smooth transition. So if that's too high for us, we can just move that down and create a bigger hole there. So now we're nearly done with our ring. So we have all of these areas, and you can see, I mean, some of these look a little bit pinched, but I can just move that. Kind of adjust that so that it is flowing more naturally. And again, these are maybe the two biggest reasons why I think you might consider using T-Splines. One is that you can really design while you model. So after I get the string put together, I can explore different variations just by tweaking the surface. And the other reason to use T-Splines is that all of these transitions and blends, they just kind of come as part of the T-Spline surface. So anything that you want blend smoothly together, just merge or bridge it, and it will be a smooth transition. One thing that T-Splines does by default, though, is it kind of everything is really quite smooth. So if you want to tighten anything up, that's when you use something like the insert edge command that we introduced at the very beginning. So I'm going to run this insert edge command again. And you can either select one edge loop or you can select an edge ring. So I'll go ahead and select an edge loop again just by double-clicking to select the whole thing really quickly. And now you can see, let's see, I'll do both sides off. So I'm just going to do it on one side. As you add in more edges, so if I just click right here, the same effect happens that happened just when we were doing the practice, is it tightens up the curvature. So let me undo that so you can see the difference here. So you see how that's very smooth. And then by adding in an edge, you can see how that just tightens that up nicely. So we can come around the ring, and any place where we want to have a tighter edge, we can insert some edges. So maybe on this side of the ring, we want it to be a tighter edge. Then we'll go ahead and insert some edges. So a fast way to do some of the selection is if I do paint selection edge ring, you can see how that selects all of these edges in a ring here. And the insert edge command can also take that as an input. So go insert edge. And run that. You can see again that just tightens that up. So there's still some subtlety here, but it's a lot tighter than it was before. So we can go ahead over here, do that same thing. So select an edge, select edge ring, and insert edge. And you can just tighten that up. So we can do that here if we want to, or we can leave this as a smoother interior and have the tighter edges on the outside. But now that we have the T-spine ring, how we would like it? So maybe we could still do some more tweaking here, just to pull this hard down. Let's blot them down a little bit. I think we can also do it something we like weighting these edge points. If we weight these points, it will. You see how that even makes it a tighter bottom there. But now that we're done with a T-splines design, going to Rhino is just a push button conversion. So we can just use this convert button, and I'll right-click it to convert to Rhino surfaces. And let me hit F3 so we can just show how the surface layout is here. Now the T-spline is just split up into Rhino surfaces. And so you can use any of your Rhino commands on this T-spline model now. But that's kind of the introductory webinar that we have for you today. So what we've done is just introduced some T-splines commands that by mastering just these few T-splines commands, you can create a lot of models that you'd like that T-splines is good for, and then use those to create a ring model. So our hope is that by using T-splines, you can be able to design while you model and then also get nice smooth transitions that make it easy to make design iterations.